Pmax campaigns have been doing so much better in the last several months in my accounts that by now I've moved most of my shopping campaigns to Pmax. A serious Pmax problem, though, remains its limited reporting capabilities. For example, Pmax will run video ads in addition to shopping, search and display, but it won't show you the cost breakdown between these traffic types. Also, while Pmax allows you to create multiple asset groups inside a campaign, the individual performance metrics cannot be viewed. While Google promises to improve Pmax reporting, I found a nice solution. This simple, elegant, and free tool will show the cost breakdown between shopping, video, and other traffic, as well as performance of individual asset groups in the Pmax campaigns. Hi, I'm Andrey, and today we'll talk about the tool, how to install it, and how to view results. Let's go! The tool is a Google Ads script that you add to your Google Ads account. It was developed by the agency Savvy, which is a premium PPC agency in Australia, and uploaded to the GitHub as a public download. The link to this download will be available in the description. To open it, click on the latest version, V12 Pmax script. Then copy everything from the starting from line 38 till the end. Control C. Then open Google Ads. Click Tools and Settings, Scripts, and Plus. We're going to add a new script. Names this script something like Pmax Chart V12 from Agency Savvy, and paste your script in line 2. Okay, we need one more thing to do. Go back to the script. In line 22, copy the URL, open a new Chrome tab, paste it there. You need to create a database where results will be shown, the Google Sheet database. Click on Make a Copy. In a few seconds, you will see a new database created. Rename it as you wish. For example, this. And copy the URL. Now go back to your script and paste it over here. Okay, click authorize, select your account, allow, click preview. So far so good. It's asking to authorize again. Repeat this, click run without preview. Watch for potential errors in status. Okay, finished successfully. Go back into your database and click here. Here you see your Pmax campaigns. Okay, let's finish the setup. Go to click on scripts and now set frequency daily. I do it 2 a.m. to 3 a.m. every morning. Now to the most exciting part, viewing the results. On the first page of the database, you will see several data points. First, you will see all your Pmax campaigns running in your account. And you will see charts. They are percentage of spend of different networks inside every campaign. Three campaigns, and this is blue is shopping, red is video cost, and gray is other cost, which is search and display. On the right side, but this is in percentages, the right side shows you the spend in real time, so basically in real proportion. So this campaign spent the most, this spent on second, and this is just started, it spent the least amount. And finally, on top right part, you will see the chart showing how the shopping and video cost and other cost network have evolved over time. So you'll see in the beginning, like 30 days ago, there were spikes in video costs. Then they subsided and they're almost non-existent. And the same, you'll see the other traffic, which is kind of good idea. It shows you probably 30 days ago, there were some changes made in the campaign. And usually at that time, Pmax starts trying different networks, different types of ads. And we will see these movements. If you click on a campaign, you will see kind of the more detailed chart of this campaign traffic between networks. So you will see the shopping cost here, video is here, and other costs are here. So we see basically when campaign is stable, it's mostly running shopping ads. Next step, campaigns, will show you more or less the same information, but in a numerical format. Then you will see also some overview of the ads, the percentage, the total, total assets, and also even quality of your headlines. Then you will see the all assets group running in your campaigns and their performance. Impressions, clicks, cost, conversions, value, and ROAS. This is the best part of this tool because you cannot find it in Google Ads. Then you will see impressions. So here you need to select the campaign. And then you will see impressions between the asset groups in the campaign across the last 30 days, here in the chart form and here in numerical form. Then on other tabs, you see similar information, but this is a costs. Cost, you can see also breakdown of costs. The next tab shows you value. Value is a revenue of the campaign, the results. And it shows you which asset group delivered this revenue. For example, the black line is, okay, black line is total, but we cannot really see from here. We can probably see on the right part here is, we see revenue and it comes from tabletops asset group. Yeah, so this is really good snapshot. It tells you how your asset groups are performing inside your Pmax campaigns. And finally, there is a really nice chart of a top 10 products across all Pmax campaign for the last 30 days. These are by cost, these top 10 products by number of conversions, then campaigns that spent but didn't bring any sales, and finally, top 10 products by revenue in the past 30 days. Important that this is across all Pmax campaigns. You cannot split it per campaign. You cannot change the date range. It's always last 30 days. This tool is so good that I'm using it daily for the Pmax analysis and optimization. I hope you will too. Thank you and have a great day.